Hello everyone, welcome to the SGS tutorial. Here I came with the second lecture, that is the stone copper phase or the chalcolithic period. So we first start with the chalcolithic settlements. Towards the end of the Neolithic period began the use of metals. The metals to be used first was copper, and several cultures were based on the use of stone and copper implements. Such a culture is called Chalcolithic. The earliest settlements belonging to this phase are found in southeastern Rajasthan, the western part of Madhya Pradesh, western Maharashtra, and also in eastern India. In southeastern Rajasthan, two sites are excavated, that is, one is Ahar and other is Giluth. I can show you in the map, that is here. Is Ahar and this is Giluth, IV and PI. They lie in the dry zone of Banas Valley. In western Madhya Pradesh, in Malwa, Kayatha and Iran have been exposed. Here is Kayatha and this is Iran has been exposed. Several chalcolithic sites such as Jorue, Nevasa, Daimabad in Ahmadnagar district, Chandoli, Songaon, Namgaon in Pune district, and Nashik has been excavated. So here are those sites: Jorue, Nevasa, Daimabad, Namgaon. Here all these sites. All these Maharashtra sites were located in semi-arid areas, mostly on brown black soil, which had pear and bubble vegetation but fell in the riverine tracts. In addition to this, we have Navdatoli situated on the Narmada. Here the one is Navdatoli. In eastern India, beside the Chiran on the Ganga, mention may be made of Pondurajar Dibi in Budawan district and Mahistal in Minnapur district in West Bengal. Here is the Pondurajar Dibi. The people belonging to this culture use small tools and weapons made of stone, in which the stone belt occupied an important position. In many places, the stone blade industry flourished, although the stone axes continued to be used. It is obvious that such areas were not situated far from the hills, but at the same time, many are found in the riverine tracts. In certain settlements, copper implements are found in good numbers. In Ahar and Giluth, which lay more or less than dry zones of the Banas River Valley in Rajasthan. At Ahar, the stone axes or blades are completely absent. On the other hand, hand axes and other objects made of copper are numerous because raw copper is locally available. But in Giluth, we find a stone blade industry. Flat, rectangular copper axes are found in Jorue and Chandoli in Maharashtra. The people of stone copper phase use different types of pottery, one of which is black and red and seems to have been widely prevalent. Here is the black and red ware. And here is also one pottery. So it was thrown on wheel and occasionally painted with white linear design. People living in Madhya Pradesh and Maharashtra produced channel spouted pots, tisses on stand and bowls on stand. Here is the bowls on stand. It would be wrong to think that all the people who used black and red over pottery possessed the same culture. We can notice differences in their forms of pottery and implements. The people of southwestern Rajasthan, western Madhya Pradesh, western Maharashtra domesticated animals and cultivated food grains. They kept cows, sheep, goats, pigs, and buffaloes and hunted deer. Remains of camel have also been found. It is not clear that whether they are acquainted with horse. People produced wheat, rice, bajra, and also produced lentil, black gram, green gram, grass pea. All the fruit grains are found at Navdatoli situation on the bank of Narmada. They also produced bear and linseed. Cotton was produced in the black cotton soil of the Deccan, and ragi and bajra and several millets were cultivated in the lower Deccan. In eastern India, fish hooks have been found in Bihar and West Bengal, where rice also found. The Chalcolithic people were not generally acquainted with bronze bricks. They used more bricks, wattle, and top, and seems to be have been thatched house. At Inagaon, in the earlier Chalcolithic phase in western Maharashtra, large mud houses with ovens and circular peat house have been discovered. In the latter phase, we have a house with 5 rooms, 4 rectangular and 1 is circular. This would suggest their families were large. Settlements came stable and widespread in this phase, which is called a Chorwe culture. This culture is called so that because its type site is provided by Chorwe, a village situated on the Parvat River. A good number of sites possesses the traits of the Chorwe culture. Every Chorwe culture was a nucleated settlement with more than 35 houses of different sizes. One is circular and the other is rectangular. We don't know much about their arts and crafts. They are clearly expert of coppersmiths and also good workers in stone. To this culture, bring a large number of very small sized stone tools which are called microliths. People knew the art of spinning, weaving because spindle holes have been found in Malwa. Cotton flax and silk threads have been found in Maharashtra. This shows these people were well accounted with the manufacture of cloth. We can form some ideas about the burial practice and the religious cults of these people. In Maharashtra, people buried their dead in under their floor of their house in the north-south position. They did not use separate cemeteries for their purpose, and was the case with the Harappans. Pots and some copper objects were deposited in the grave, obviously for the use of the dead in the next world. Terracotta figures of women suggest that the Chalcolithic people venerated the mother goddess. In Malwa and Rajasthan, stylized bull terracottas show that the bull served as the religious cult. In the stone copper phase, we find the beginnings of the social inequalities. In the graves at Chandoli and Navasa in western Maharashtra, some children were buried along with copper bead necklaces around their neck, and other children had grave gold consisting only of pots. It is evident that those who possessed these objects were affluent. This phase is continued in some areas till 1000 BC and in other areas till 800 BC, and other tools are continued until replaced by the iron tools. These are the copper tools. found from Chalcolithic period, and this is the copper god or goddess which is found in Ganga Yamuna too. Importance of the Chalcolithic phase. Except the alluvial plains and the thicky forest areas, traces of Chalcolithic cultures have been discovered all over India. In this phase, people mostly founded rural settlements on the river banks not far removed from the hills. As stated earlier, they used microliths and other stone tools supplemented by a little use of copper tools. It seems that most of them knew the art of copper smelting. They are the first to use the painted pottery. Their pots were meant for cooking, eating, and storing. The Chalcolithic communities founded the first village in India and cultivated far more cereals than is known in the case of the Neolithic communities. In particular, they cultivated barley, wheat, and lentil in Western India and rice in South and East India. Their cereals food was supplemented by the non-vegetarian food. In Western India, we have more animal food, but fish and rice formed important elements in the diet of Eastern India. It shows that remains found in Chirand and Pandurajya Dibi in Eastern India is poor, giving indication of post holes and round houses. The burial practices were different in Maharashtra. The dead body was placed in north-south position, but in South India or in the east-west position. Almost complete and extended burial obtained in Maharashtra, but post-extraction or fractional burial prevailed in West Bengal. Limitations of Chalcolithic cultures. The general weakness of Chalcolithic cultures is evident from the burial of large number of children in Western Maharashtra in spite of a food producing economy. The rate of infant mortality was very high. We can't identify its causes, which might include lack of nutrition, absence of medical knowledge, or outbreak of epidemics. The stone copper culture had an essentially rural background. During its phase, the supply of copper was limited, and as a metal, copper had its limitation. By itself, a tool made of copper was brilliant. People did not know the art of mixing tin with copper and thus forgoing the much stronger and useful metal called bronze. Bronze tools are facilitated. The rise of the earliest civilization in Crete, Egypt, and Mesopotamia, but they were practically absent in the Chalcolithic phase in the major part of India. The people of stone copper age did not know the art of writing, nor did they live in cities as the people of the bronze age did. Although most stone copper age culture existing in the major part of the country are younger than the Indus Valley civilization. The copper age in India. More than 40 hoards consisting of copper objects have been found in a wide area ranging from the Chotanagpur Plateau to the Upper Gangetic Basin. But nearly half of them are concentrated in the Ganga Yamuna Doab. In other areas, we encounter stray finds of such hoards. These copper hoards comprise cells, harpoons, antennae hoards, and anthropomorphic figures. These artifacts served several purposes like fishing, hunting, fighting, but also for artisanal and agricultural At several places in the upper Gangetic basin, these objects have been discovered in association with archaeocolloid pots and some mud structures. These hordes led a settled life and were one of the earliest primitive agriculturists and artisans to settle a good portion of the Dobe. And so this shows the well technological skill and well settled life. Most copper cells have been found in the Khetri zone of Rajasthan. The period covered by the archaeocolloid pottery culture is roughly placed between 2000 BC and 1800 BC, when the archaeocolloid settlements using the copper objects disappeared. The Dobe does not show much habitation till about 1000 BC. We learn some habitation by people using black and red ware, but their habitation deposits are so thin and antiquities so pure, we can't form a clear and distinct idea of their cultural equipment. The sanctity and the religious purity attached to the copper vessels, utensils, etc. in Hindu religion may have started in the Copper Age. The copper hoard people were contemporaries of the Harappans. And the archaeocolloid pottery area in which they lived was not far removed from the Harappans. We may therefore accept some give and take between the copper using people and the bronze using Harappans, and it is called as pre-Harappan period. These are the tools, the copper tools.